Hey, I'm Justin, and I'm trying to learn game dev from scratch. It's been a journey, but the best kind of journey. I finished my first simple 2D game, and I learned some basics, but I still have a long way to go. On that note, I think it's time to learn some 3D. This won't be my first experience ever with 3D. I played the block game as a kid, and now that I'm 30, I almost have it figured out. My first experience with 3D when it comes to programs, though, would be a lyric video that I made when I was first learning After Effects 10 years ago. I made it over the course of a few months, and with each new verse and chorus of the song, I wanted to implement whatever new thing I learned at the time. I can't play the original audio because the song I used is very copyrighted, but you might be able to guess what it is from the lyrics. The cool thing is that you can see this progression by watching the video from beginning to end. Like, at first, I was learning about basic keyframe animation. Then a little later is when I started learning about animating along a path and using a 3D camera. I then took that a step further as I really tried to place 2D objects in 3D space. Then I tried out some more complex animations and had the audio control the movement. I especially had fun with this segment. Then the puppet tool to bend his knees. But I wanted to do something different for the end of the song. I wanted to take this dancing 2D stick figure and turn it into a 3D concert. Did it look professional? Heck no, I was winging it, but it did help me get more comfortable with the program. I think I might still have the photo that I took to show how long it took for my poor laptop to export the video. Hold on. Yep, here it is. Honestly, not too bad for an old laptop. Now, After Effects is by no means a 3D modeling program, and extruding rectangles to make a stick figure dance is very different from the sculpting and vertex manipulation in a program that's designated for this. A program like Blender. But there's a problem. Blender is huge. There's a lot you can do with it, which means there's a lot to learn. And the shortcuts. This isn't a program that I can just mess around with and expect to learn on my own. I need a starting point. I need something that will familiarize myself with the program so I can learn the basics.
This is Blender. Open source 3D software that can be used to make animations, visual effects, games.
So I started with the famous donut series by Blender Guru. I'll have a link in the description to it if you're looking for a great beginner series for learning Blender. It helped to demystify a lot about how Blender works, and over the course of about a week or so, my donut renders got better and better. Until he gave homework in one of the tutorials to make a plate on my own. It felt like it should be so simple until I tried it. I got humbled real quick. You see, a program like Blender is especially difficult for me because, as I've stated multiple times on this channel, my art skills are lacking. You want to know something though? Growing up, I had my different phases of dream jobs that I wanted to do when I was older, and for a good while, I wanted to be an artist when I grew up. This is real, I loved drawing, and one of my favorite childhood Christmas gifts that I received was a DigiDraw. What I need to do is start channeling this. You see, the same person who wanted to be an artist is still there somewhere, and I love the feeling of creating things. I know I can increase my skill in this area with some hard work and practice. So I continued on with the tutorial series until I finally made it to the final render. I had some complications with the export, which was unfortunate because the export took about 14 hours to complete. After eventually realizing that my blending mode was messed up, I was able to fix it, and another 14 hours later, we have the very first thing that I ever made in Blender. I'm really happy with how it turned out, but this was me following closely to a tutorial. Now I need to actually apply what I learned to prove that I did really learn something. I need something easy just to prove that I can make something on my own and make that kid who wanted to be an artist when he grew up proud. Okay, hold on, I get it. It's nothing amazing, but that's to be expected. But this is the first thing that I ever made in Blender, and this is the second. Why is there such a big difference in quality? When you're following a tutorial, you're able to copy everything exactly the same as the video you're watching, click for click, button press for button press. No one should expect to be an expert in anything after watching just one tutorial. There's a lot that I still don't fully understand about Blender, but I won't know what those things are unless I try to make things on my own and mess up. This is also why it's so easy to get stuck in tutorial hell, where you watch tutorial after tutorial but don't try to apply what you've learned and allow yourself to mess up. That's dangerous because if you don't take the time to practice what you learned on your own, you can become dependent on tutorials to make anything. So this jump down in quality is drastic, but necessary. It reminds me that even though I technically did create this, my Blender skills are here. This is fine with me though. I know I have a long way to go, but it's not about how fast I get there. It's the climb. In the spirit of making things, I decided to create a little challenge for my Discord server. And by the way, if you didn't know that we have a Discord server, you do now. I'll have a link in the description, so feel free to join the community. Anyway, the challenge was to make something Autumn related. Game dev is the combination of so many different art styles, including graphics, music, animation, and so much more. I wanted to give the opportunity for people to choose to either continue to refine the skills they're already good at, or work on the skills that they'd like to improve. What you're seeing are submissions from this challenge, which has been awesome to see. Even the music playing right now is a submission titled Nostalgia Lost Its Leaves and was created in VR by someone in the Discord. I wanted to make something for this challenge too, and as you probably guessed, I chose to make something in Blender. I figured a pumpkin would be a step up in difficulty for my 3D table, and it still felt doable. The funny thing is, I felt like this went a lot smoother than I thought it would. Something I started doing is something that I did when I was first learning After Effects, which is I've been watching videos of people just making random things in the software. I'm not following along, just watching. I feel like it's been helping me get a little more familiar with the program. It causes me to pick up on certain features that I didn't know were there before, or remind me of other features that I would have forgotten about. Sometimes I won't know the shortcut for a certain feature, but know that it exists because I remember seeing someone use it in a video, so it helps me know what to Google. Anyway, after some time and a lot of trial and error trying to fix weird wrinkles in the mesh, we now have the third thing I ever made in Blender. I can't wait to see my 100th, and I'm looking forward to seeing more of what you guys are creating too. If themed challenges like this seem interesting to you, click the link in the description to join the Discord. I plan on doing more of these in the future, and it's been great to be able to talk to everyone about game dev. Besides that, I'll see you in the next video. Keep learning.